Hello.
Hello.
This is Kirk and Tiffany with Seeking the Glory of God Ministries. And the Lord has given us a word that we can bring to you right now.
This is a vision that Kirk received on October 24 of 2024. And I'll read it in first person as though I'm Kirk. And then he can talk to us about it when I'm done. So today the Lord Jesus stopped by and asked me to come with him. I was seated on the couch, but I walked through the wall of the room with him. He asked if I was ready. I answered that I was. We took off like a flash, and in a moment we were back again at the library where I had been given the book on power to read. So as a side note, Kirk read a book on power in heaven several months ago, so that's what he's referencing. Okay, back to this vision. We came to rest in an aisle, and the Lord selected a book. On its spine, it read Power and Glory. He handed it to me and said, "Prophet, read this. Take your time." I looked at the book and opened it. All the writing on the spine and in the book was in some other language, but I could read it as easily as English, maybe even better. It started out on the first page, which read, "Using his power, bringing him glory." Though I call them pages, it was not like flipping pages. Again, like when I read the book on power, the text seemed to change very fast. But I was not hurrying to read it. The book just kept up with the speed at which I read. In a short time, I was done. As I write this, I do not remember the whole text of the book. But as I closed it, I could only think about how he gives power out to glorify himself. In fact, wherever his power is manifested, it glorifies him. I handed the book back to the Lord, and he placed it back where he had gotten it from. He then turned to me and asked if I understood what I had read. I looked at the Lord, and all I could think of was to answer, "Lord, I'm not sure if I completely understand. Have I received the understanding that you desired?" He smiled, and I could just feel pure love coming from him. He answered, "Yes, you completely understand." I stared at him and said, "I don't feel like I really know what it actually said." I didn't feel confident like I had learned what it said. He just smiled even bigger. "It's in your heart," he said. Next thing I knew, I was back on the couch praying. Bless God.
Yeah, that's kind of amazing that that feeling of knowing that I had done what I'd been told to do, read the book, and not knowing in my head what I had read. I remember the last time, the one on power, I had the vision and I told you the vision and you were like
what did it say?
What did it say? And I was like, I don't know. And yet the conference that we just had was on power. Between the time that vision came of the book and I had read the book on power and the conference, stuff about power just kept bubbling up and kept coming in visions and words and so on. And so I expect this is probably going to be the same, but it is kind of strange that you read a book and the Lord says, "Oh, you got it all." And you're like, "I don't have anything. I just don't know." And yet, he brings it. He brings it.
He does.
I know, too, that we need to have this brought to us at a rate that we can understand it and receive it well and practice it and whatever else we got it, what we're supposed to do. So, yeah, that's an amazing trip to the library. To have a book handed to you by Jesus, okay, read this, and it goes so quick, and then it's done, and he says, you got it all, and you're like, I don't think so, but.
Yeah, but when something is in your heart, you do have it.
Yeah.
It's in your heart.
Yep.
It's different than a head knowledge.
Yep.
Which is and something I'm sure you can forget.
He'll bring it to
he
me.
He will. He'll bring it back.
Yep. You know, it kind of reminds you of, like, when you've read the Bible, which I'm terrible, terrible at memorization, okay? I've never really practiced it and never been real good at it. It's just not something that I can do. And yet, when the Lord wants me to say something about Scripture, he just brings it, and sometimes I know where it is. It's just kind of amazing, so... Yeah,
and I would say what we need to take away from the vision right now is that power glorifies the Lord. He gives out power to glorify himself. That's the purpose.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I came away feeling like that. I felt like the general feeling after reading the book was that, you know, he said, those who want power will not have it, but those who loved me shall have the power. That's the way I felt. It's like anyone who wants to practice power has to practice loving him and doing things the way he wants and practicing the power in a way that he desires you to exercise it. If it just comes out of your head, well, that person made me mad and, you know, I'm going to zap them or something, that's not going to work. It's according to the will of the Lord and according to his, Christ in you.
Right.
So.
For sure.
So, yeah.
That's good. And if you have questions, you know, about prophets, we have the Prophet's Handbook here. So even if you're not a prophet, you're not called to the fivefold prophet office, it's still good to read to understand prophets and how they operate. And then, of course, the World and Church Prophecies book we have up here, too. Just because a lot of these prophecies we're seeing begin to happen, and it's really fascinating to read through that.
So. Mm-hmm. So we forgot to put the clock up.
Oh, we forgot to put the clock up. So let me just stick it up there a minute so you know. It's we're recording this October 25 at 2:54. There you go. Right. There's the clock. There it was.
There it
we
was.
Hope you saw it. Oh, this is
okay,
great.
So we'll get used to this new studio after all. Yeah, so Jesus loves you so much, and we got the clock. There we go.
Amen.
Destiny Road partners with organizations that rescue and give honorable employment to human trafficking victims.
That's right. We sell jewelry, purses, bags, tea, clothing, household items, and much more.
You may also find books by Tiffany and Kirk on Destiny Road or by visiting Amazon.com and searching under Tiffany Root. Thank you, and God bless you.